This is the introduction to rapid pain control. My name is Tom Condon.
And my name is Carol Erickson. Now with this side A, we would like to talk about the best way to use and experience rapid pain control.
The main purpose of this tape is to provide you with the ability to tap your own natural capacity for pain control, and to use it when and where you need it, consciously or unconsciously, using it perhaps without even realizing that you're using it. The purpose of pain is to get our attention that something is wrong, protect us from further damage, and to request care. It's in this sense that a little bit of pain is a good thing, and sometimes you may need to keep a small percentage of a pain in order to monitor body functioning and healing. Pain generally occurs in two ways, occasional or accidental, and chronic and constant. This tape can be equally effective to both kinds. It will also work well for acute pain for which there's a well-established cause and for which the treatment is drugs. You do not need to be hypnotized in order to use your pain control capacity. It's a total response on the part of your conscious mind, your unconscious mind, and your body working together as a team.
Pain and comfort are conditions we all have experienced at various times in our life, and you have experienced them in different ways, with different degrees of awareness, at different levels, in different parts of your body. So it is important to note that just as your body recognizes pain, it also recognizes comfort. Your mind is very powerful and has the capacity to reach into the memory banks and comprehend this understanding, and to appreciate how very well the memory banks can provide an old sense of comfort from your own deep pool of personal learnings and experiences, as well as data and information that you have developed over the years.
Because every day we experience and process millions of sensations, perceptions and thoughts and awarenesses, far more than we can consciously keep track of. Even as I'm speaking now, you're probably unaware of certain sensations in your fingertips or toes. In fact, on a conscious level, you regularly ignore most of what your senses are telling you, because it's simply too much to keep track of. The fact that our conscious awareness is limited is a wonderful adaptation. It means that we're free to pay attention to what is most important or interesting or comfortable at a particular moment in time and ignore the rest of our sensory experience.
So with that in mind, and a recognition that you really prefer comfort and that it's really a habit of your body to adjust to comfort, can recognize that you have the deep inner resources already in place to experience bodily comfort. You also can appreciate how you have the ability to remember and to forget, and it is such a gift. You probably don't remember all the names of the other children who were in the first grade with you. It would only get in your way. You also forget the groceries you needed from the store last month as you focus on the current situation.
Pain control is actually a naturally occurring experience in everyone's life at some point in time, whether you realize it or not. Nearly everyone has had the experience of cutting themselves while involved in some physical activity, perhaps working in a garden or hiking, and you only noticed later that you had a small cut or scratch or blister that you couldn't remember getting. You know logically you must have felt pain when it happened, and yet you have no memory of it. There may have been other times when you were pleasantly surprised or distracted or absorbed in something and forgot some discomfort you were having. Sometimes people report forgetting altogether about having a headache as they sit through an engrossing, interesting, or entertaining movie. In some countries, people in warm saunas go outside, walk through the snow, and feel quite comfortable swimming in icy cold water.
Sometimes your body can send you a signal, perhaps a twinge, or a twitch, or a tweak, and it's important to respond to that body language talking to you. Many people, when they think about previous painful times, can remember how it felt, and they can anticipate how it would feel in the future. However, it's comforting to realize that you can shift your focus of attention, choosing to forget the feeling of past pain and letting go of future anticipated pain, and shift into another way of perceiving your body sensations when it sends you a signal now.
And when you've just come through a difficult, painful experience, it's natural to begin to forget about the difficulty as soon as possible. The difference with chronic or consistent pain is that if you forget your pain for a little while, it can sometimes come back to surprise you unpleasantly. As a kind of mental defense against this, the chronic pain patient develops a state of mind where she or he is always anticipating as well as remembering pain. It is in this sense that chronic pain is one-third remembered, one-third actual, and one-third anticipated. It is in this sense that the chronic pain patient actually only has one-third of the pain that she or he thinks they do.
And yet, you can remember a fun nursery rhyme of a children's song that you learned a long time ago. The capacity for remembering and forgetting is there for you all the time, and it is very intriguing how you learn to discriminate and choose various ideas, feelings, aromas, states of perceiving, and levels of comfort. Now, on side B, you will be hearing our voices, both separately and together, speaking to you as you play, use, and listen to this tape. Also, you will be hearing other sounds as well, such as music, various nature sounds, and lifelike situations, all choreographed and blending together to provide a thoroughly rich experience. Many of the sound effects are processed to give them an especially lifelike three-dimensional quality.
And we would like to make some suggestions that may be helpful in maximizing your experience as you listen and relax a little and set the stage to have your own restful and satisfying experience on side B.
The experience on side B, as we are defining it, is an altered state of awareness with an inward focus. Whether or not you have ever been in a clearly defined official hypnotic trance, you have doubtless been in many natural trance states. You might have known these as reveries or daydreams or as an absent-minded set of thoughts. Examples of common natural hypnotic trances occur, for example, when you are reading a very good book and your attention is really focused, your interest truly held within the focus of that reading, so that you forget about your surroundings. Or perhaps just sitting and watching a fire in a fireplace, perhaps enjoying a gentle warmth as you let your mind drift, watching the colors and size and shapes of the flames as they keep changing into one another, and your attention is absorbed in a kind of contemplation as you hear the logs crackle and pop, and you may be seeing or remembering things of significance in some way, things of meaning and interest to your whole self.
Or you might have experienced a particular aroma, such as hot, spicy apple cider or fresh-cut grass, reminding you in some way of other times and places in your life, special times within your innermost feelings, thoughts, and memories. And it's really a pleasure sometimes to provide yourself with some relaxation and time to process things and reflect within the deep comfort and good feelings that can be experienced within yourself at times when you most need to. So since you've likely experienced your own natural hypnotic trances many times in one way or another, it's nice to know that you can use this trance time for the particular purpose you desire from this tape. It may be just to relax and enjoy yourself, to sleep deeply and comfortably, or to focus usefully on your own particular goals at this time, or to learn or grow or develop or achieve something for yourself in some ways that will be satisfying and enhancing to your comfort.
Thus, since this hypnosis is for you and will be experienced by you with your own focus for your own purposes, it is really a self-hypnosis, one in which you have complete control over the direction of your experience. You can at first practice going into hypnosis more and more easily, just getting used to the state in your own way. You can use the special focus time for yourself and your goals, or simply relax and enjoy yourself, and then come out whenever is the right time for you. You will always be able to take good care of yourself and respond to your environment as needed. Anytime you need to, you can come out of trance and exercise your power of choice and decide whether anything in your environment requires your attention, as well as deciding what kind of a hypnotic experience is right for your needs at any particular time.
Our tapes are merely resources designed to be helpful to your individual needs and pursuits. Since we can't know exactly what those are, you'll have to make decisions at times as to how to most appropriately tailor the use to your needs. We try to include in each tape the maximum number of options for each individual to pick and choose from. If some particular phrasing or image doesn't work for you, feel free to translate our words into something that will work for you. If any feelings of discomfort ever happen to occur, feel free to decide whether to make an adjustment within your experience or to stop listening to the tape at that time. If a feeling of discomfort were to persist, you might make a decision about whether to seek appropriate medical or psychological care. Since we can't be there with you, we trust your unconscious mind, and your conscious mind will make the most appropriate and healthy choices for your well-being and benefit at all times.
Also, one note of caution. Never play or use our tapes while operating a motor vehicle or doing anything that requires your total attention. They will definitely interfere with the safe operation of machinery. After listening to a tape during the daytime, please leave about 15 minutes before going on to any new activity.
Now, on side B, the hypnotic approach we use is called multi-hypnotic evocation. Multi-evocation means that there will be more than one voice speaking throughout the trance, accompanied by a variety of special effects and music. This is a relatively new approach that combines Ericksonian hypnosis with metaphorical environments and three-dimensional sound. Multi-evocation is based on years of research and decades of clinical experience, and for many people the results are extraordinarily helpful.
At first, as you listen to the two of us speaking at the same time, often speaking of different but related things, you might feel bewildered or confused. It may remind you of arriving at a party or a social gathering where everyone is talking at once. And it does take a few moments for you to tune into what you are most interested in. All of the sound on side B, including the voices, will have a lifelike, realistic quality if you listen to the tape with headphones or sit equal distances between two stereo speakers. This quality makes the tapes rather unusual to listen to the first few times.
And again, remember that you have choices in how you listen. You might at first begin by listening to just one voice and some of the sounds in the background, or you may be most interested in the other voice and some other things that are going on. You might want to float back and forth between the two voices with your attention, picking and choosing the images and sensations that are right for you at a particular time. Many people tell us that they simply are content to enjoy the music of the two voices and simply drift off into a comfortable place of their own choosing. You may have your own favorite ways of listening, some of which develop after many listenings, so that the various aspects of this multidimensional experience can serve you best at particular times and places in the days and weeks and months and moments to come.
Now, whenever you are ready, rewind to the beginning of side B.